after the World Bank, the Organization for Economic Cooperation and Development, sharply lowers its global growth forecast for 2022, the OECD sees the global economy growing 3% this year, down from its 4.5% estimate back in December. The main culprit, Russia's invasion of Ukraine. The group warns the world will pay a hefty price for Russia's war, saying global growth will be substantially lower while inflation will be higher and more persistent. It clarifies while they are not seeing a global recession, there are many downside risks to the outlook. Meanwhile, any quick relief from the soaring costs is unlikely, with inflation expected to peak at 8.5% this year in OECD countries before slipping to 6% in 2023. Transport regulators have approved a 1 peso fare hike for public utility jeepneys effective today, June 9. This is in response to a petition filed by transport groups amid the unabated rise in fuel prices. The fare increase will bring the base fare or the first 4 kilometers to 10 pesos. The fare hike is limited to the National Capital Region as well as regions 3 and 4. Discounts will still be given to persons with disability, senior citizens, and students. Meanwhile, the regulatory board will hear a separate petition to increase the base fare by 5 pesos on June 28, the last week of the Duterte administration.
Motorists again call on the Philippine government to suspend the excise tax on fuel as oil prices continue to rise. More from Avenel Chico.
As fuel prices rose, worker Janelle has started to use his bicycle and decided to temporarily retire his motorcycle to minimize expenses.
Standby muna sa bahay kasi mahal yung gasolina ngayon eh, mahirap yung buhay. Yung dati kasi magkano lang yun, nasa 50 lang yun eh, 53. Ngayon, wala, tumaas na ngayon, magkano na ngayon ng 78 na ngayon, mahirap ang buhay.
Gasoline now retails at 74 to 97 pesos per liter, while diesel is at 75 pesos to 90 pesos in Metro Manila. Bayan patrollers have also sent fuel prices in their areas where fuel now costs more than 80 pesos per liter. In Palawan, prices are now more than 90 pesos per liter. Motorists are asking the government to consider suspending the excise tax on petroleum.
Sana iano nila yung excise tax ng petrolyo para kahit papaano matulungan yung mga katulad naming motorista.
Kung makakatulong sa pangkalahatan, eh, okay lang po.
Mas okay po yung tanggalin muna yung tax para habang wala pa, at least mababa yung konsumo ng namin.
Removing excise tax means a slash of 10 pesos per liter for gasoline, 6 pesos for diesel, and 5 pesos for kerosene. If government decides to suspend the biofuels component of fuel, gasoline will be cheaper by 3 to 4 pesos per liter and diesel by 1 to 2 pesos per liter. But incoming Senate Ways and Means Committee Chairman Sherwin Gatchalian says it is better to increase the targeted help to the transport sector.
Kahit doblehin pa natin yan to about 6 billion, mas mura pa rin siya kaysa mawala yung 200 billion plus. No? So para sa akin, yan ang mas epesyente pa. Pero hindi ko rin sinasara yung isip ko sa pagtatanggal ng excise tax, Alvin, lalo na kung humaba itong gera.
Gatchalian is not in favor of raising income tax but is studying the possibility of raising taxes on non-essential goods and services. The senator says the BIR should resolve collection efficiency issues, but when asked if the tax bureau should collect the tax on the Marcos estate, Gatchalian insists the issue is political.
Political ploy nga yung narrative na yun eh, no? Lumabas lang ng politika and obviously political story ang politika at pang-politika lang yun. Makikita ho natin lumabas pa yan sa mga katunggaling kandidato, no? At kung mayroong ganyan nga, dapat lumabas sa bibig ng BIR yan, lumabas sa bibig ng DOF.
Finance Secretary Carlos Dominguez earlier said the government is bent on collecting any tax due on the Marcos estate. Alvin Olchico, ABS-CBN News.